Hey guys, welcome to Web Dev Cloud. Today in this video, we will be looking at the API Gateway in AWS. So here we are in the home screen, and from the search, we will search for API Gateway. And let's click and open it into the new tab. So API Gateway is basically the service which lets you create API endpoint. Here we are in the list of APIs where some APIs are already created by me in the past. Let's create new one for now to understand. So let's click on create API button, and from the type we'll choose REST API for now. So we can also import it from various tools. So as of now, we are going to build one. So let's click on build. Let's provide some names, say sample-api. Description is not mandatory, so we will leave it blank. And from the endpoint type, there are actually three type of endpoint provided in API. So first is regional, means it will be in the same region, means this one, North Virginia, or it is also called US East 1. Yes, so it will be in the same region. Also, edge optimized means it will use CloudFront endpoints, which means less latency, and we'll cover that thing later in some other video. And private means only available in AWS network. So for now, we'll choose regional and click on create API. Here we are redirected to the screen where we can create resources and methods to our API endpoints. One default resource is root, means the slash. So let's create method inside that. So choose action, and from there click on create method, and it will show one drop down, and from drop down we can choose our method. So for now, let's choose get method and click on this right mark. Here are some options related to our method get that we just specified here. So first is integration type, under which we are going to choose Lambda function for now. So Lambda is basically the serverless service which lets you write your own code to run via this API endpoint. So for now, we will choose Lambda function, and also select this proxy integration type, and our region is going to be the same, US East 1. And for Lambda function, we just have not created one to attach to this API. So before saving this, we are going to create one Lambda function, and then we specified here before saving this. So let's jump into the Lambda services. So from the search, let's write Lambda and open it into the new tab. So these are the options to our Lambda function. First one is the name of the function, in which we will specify sample-api-function. And the second drop down is of runtime, which is basically the list of programming language that is available for you to write your code. So for now, we will choose default, which is Node.js. You can select any of the language. It's .NET, .NET Core, Go, Java 11, Python 3.9, and Ruby 2.7 are the available option along with this Lambda function. So for now, we'll choose Node.js. And so in advanced settings, let's not choose anything for now, and let's just create function. So our function has been created. Let's click on this index.js. So this is our function. Let me just make it big. So this is some boilerplate code which is generated with Node.js runtime, which basically gives response with string saying hello from Lambda. let's test this function. So let's click on this. So first of all, we need to configure some test event. So let's just call it sample test event, and let's just not worry about the other parameters for now, and let's just click on save. So our test configuration has been created. Now we just need to click on that event. So click on test, and here you can see, let me just make it big again. Oops. So here you can see the response, which is provided by our Node.js Lambda function along with the status code 200, and the body says hello from Lambda. So later when we attach this function with our API, we will be then execute this code via our endpoint. Also here I would like you to know that whenever we make any changes in this function, then we first need to deploy this, and then we can test the same in order to reflect the changes into the output. So if we test, let's say one dash hello from Lambda, and then here it shows that changes not deployed. So first we need to deploy these changes. So once changes is being deployed, then we can test the function with the new changes. So now it is saying one dash hello from Lambda in our response. So our Lambda function with Node.js runtime has been created. So now let's jump back to our method configuration in API Gateway. Or let me make it smaller. So, and from the function name, let's try to provide our newly created function name. So I think it is not showing as of now. So let me just reload this entire page. Let me again check this, and okay, so here it is now, sample API function. So now as soon as we call this endpoint, we'll basically going to make a call to this Lambda function. So now let's just save this configuration and click on okay. Okay, so now our root resource, which means slash, is all set along with its get method. So now in order to run this endpoint, we need to deploy this API. So from this action, let's choose deploy API, and in order to deploy, we need to select deployment stage. As of now there is no stage, so we'll create one. Click on new stage. Let's say our stage name is development, so let me call it dev just, and just click on deploy button. So now our API has been deployed, and this is my URL by which I can invoke this API. So now we will copy this invoke URL and paste it inside any REST client. So we are having Postman, which is the best among all. So let's open Postman and paste this URL inside the request URLs field. And from the method, our API supported get method for this endpoint. So we'll choose get, which is default as well. And for the rest of fields, we don't need to pass anything. So now just click on send button. And in response section, we can see, let me make it big, we can see our response is there, one dash hello from Lambda. Let us create one more resource with post method. So let's get back to the API gateway section, and under this root, let me create one more resource by clicking create resource and provide the name of resource. Let's say test. and click on create resource button, and under this resource we need to create method which is going to be post. And let us also set up this method as well. So again, Lambda function, proxy integration, yes, Lambda region is the same, US East one, and Lambda function, in this case we will create one more Lambda function. So let's go to the functions and create one more function. Let's call it sample API post function, and let's keep rest of the things as it is and click on create function. So here is again the boilerplate code. Let's make some change in this string. Call it this is response for post method and deploy these changes. Okay, so here we are good. We don't want to test the Lambda function here, so we do not need to create this configure test event for this function. Let's attach this newly created Lambda function to this post method. So everything is good. Here we need to select sample API post function and click on save, click OK, and our resource has been set up with post method here. Okay, now so again we need to deploy these changes that we made. So again, click on deploy API, stage dev and deploy. So at the end we can get the invoke URL. So to obtain the invoke URL of newly created resource, we just need to click on the method of that resource under the stage section. So here is our invoke URL of our post method. So let's click it, let's copy that actually and put it inside the postman. And now here we need to remember that we need to switch method from get to post in order to invoke this URL, and click on send. Okay, so here we are getting our response that we have configured. Actually there is a typo in the last method spelling. So this is the response that we configured inside our new Lambda function. So far we have created and tested API that is public, which doesn't have any authentication. So as soon as we copy and paste our invocation URL and specify method and hit enter, it will give us the response without any authentication. So in order to make our API secure, we can configure API key to our API endpoints. Let's get back to the API console and create API key. So go to API keys and from the action choose create API key. Let's call it sample API key and let's keep it auto generate and click on save. Now we will be requiring this API key while calling the API endpoint because we are making it secure. So let's save this key somewhere in editor. Let's just make it visible, copy it and open the editor and paste it here. We will require this later when we will be calling our API endpoint. Also with the API key, we need to define its usage plan along with the state that we want our API to be deployed. Usage plan basically defines the limit over the API key. So click here to add the usage plan. Here first we need to define our usage plan. So let us create usage plan and attach to this API key. Let's just click on usage plans and create our own usage plan. Let's say sample usage plan and let's leave description empty. Rate request per second, let's keep it 10. Also burst request, let's keep it 10. Let's just uncheck this checkbox and don't worry about this warning. click on next, add API stage. Yes, we would like to add the stage. This will be used for sample API and for dev stage. Yes, and then click on next, click on done. So our usage plan has been created and it has been attached to sample API with dev stage. We can also check the same with our API key as well. So let's go to the API key and we can see there in API keys here we need to attach that plan, sample usage plan. Okay, so our usage plan have been defined. Also in method of our resource we need to make API key enable. So here as of now API key says it's not required, so let's go into the get method and under method request here where it says API key required it says false for now, so let's make it to true. So now whenever we call this endpoint it will authenticate using this API key, otherwise it will not give us the response that we are getting as of now. So we have enabled it. So now let's just test this API inside the postman again. Also let's not forget to deploy this API after this change that we have done. So let's click on deploy API, select our dev stage and click on deploy. Now we can test this API again into the postman. So let's do it. So let's copy this URL and go back to the postman to see what happens. So let's enter this URL and click on send. So now here we can see that it says forbidden. It means we are not allowed to access this API. So let's try again by entering the key. And the key we need to pass inside the header as XAPI key. Let's copy the key as well. So here is the key in postman. Let's provide the key and click on send. So here you can see as soon as we provide our key it returns us with the correct response. So this is how we can make our API secure. So this was it for the API gateway and how to call a Lambda function using API gateway and how to make our API secured using API keys and how to attach usage plan with it and so on. So this was it for this video. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, have a nice time.